I have prepared something for you that I will show you in Photoshop first, because it's a composited file that contains essentially my character rendered separately from the clothing. So I've rendered the character as well as two outfits out in layers, and I've shown this on my Patreon feed already. It's available for everyone. You can download the Photoshop file if you like. Scene file is not going to work in this case, but here we go. Canvas demo, that's it. So this is using the magic of canvases in Iray. So here it looks like I have one character and she's wearing something, but I can also take her clothing off and basically just have the character underneath it and give her a different item of clothing. And this is what Mick wanted to know. How do you do this in DAZ Studio? He says, I've seen this in some video games. I don't know how these guys do it. And it is by rendering these things out separately. So if I hide the character, I can see that not only do I have the clothing, I also have, I also have the bits that were left out for the hair. So if I bring in the character, the clothing isn't just covering that bit of hair underneath it. There's actually a gap in the clothing for where the hair is going to go. And canvases let you make all these things. So you don't see anything that would be rendered at the back here. So the straps kind of end here. And it's the same thing has happening for this outfit. So you can see the gap for the hair here. And when you line them up in Photoshop or in your game engine, you'll then see that these things do fit together, which is, you know, kind of cool. So how do we do this in DAZ Studio? By the magic of canvases indeed. And canvases are a way for multi-pass rendering. I'll show you the actual scene file that I have for this. Hectix TV, hallöchen! And thank you so much for your warm welcome from Austria. Very good, very good. Very good to see you. Welcome to the stream. A good evening to Austria. I do actually have a German channel. And my plan was, if ever I run out of things to say, I could do all my DAZ tutorials in German, because there's a huge market in Germany, or there's a huge German-speaking market, should I say. And I'm so busy that I just can't do it. But it was always my plan to make German DAZ tutorials. So, you know, it's one of those things. Maybe in the future it'll happen. Depends on how workload is just increasing. So, but, you know, if ever I get the time, I will certainly do that. So this is the scene I've just rendered out, and in the scene tab I literally have I have no other things other than one leather outfit that I can enable or disable, and then I have a purple dress outfit that I can enable or disable. Oh, actually I have to go and control click that, don't I? There we go. So this is exactly how the scene is set up, but the magic really comes in turning this, rendering this out in canvases. So canvases are happening under the render settings tab, under the advanced tab up here. So very cool stuff. And in advanced we have hardware, and then we have canvases. So if you click that, this is where all these exciting settings are hiding. And I'll show you how to set this up from scratch. I just wanted to go through what it looks like right now. So we have one canvas. Canvases can be enabled or disabled. That's the first option here. In the canvas section you can have various types of render passes. So one canvas is technically a render pass in Iray, not so much in DAZ Studio. It's an Iray feature. Important to understand, this is not something that DAZ Studio provides. It's something that Iray provides, and DAZ Studio exposes those options for us. Beauty is the stuff we see, but there's many other things that you can add here. If you had this canvas here, and you can pick whatever type of pass you want here. Beauty, diffuse, specular, glossy. So those are all things that the render engine uses underneath the hood, and if you were to render these things out separately, you can then do post-production with it in Photoshop. Like a depth pass is one of those things that you can use, that you can see later how far away from the camera were these objects in the 3D scene. Thankfully we're only concerned with the beauty, so I'm going to go and delete my second canvas. So that's the beauty canvas. That's the type of render pass we're rendering out. Then at the bottom here we have a few other settings that make more sense when we look at the very, very bottom, which is the node list. So a node is a group of items we would like to render out in that render pass. So in my case, the character doesn't actually need one, but everything that is held together with an outfit needs to be grouped as a node. So I can say all these items need to be rendered out separately. So in my case, the leather outfit has several items in it. This is essentially a mini reproduction of the scene tab. So the character isn't included in this node, but the shoes and the jacket and the pants and the undergarment is included, but not the purple dress, none of the lights. So this is what makes up the leather outfit node. And then this one here, purple dress node, similarly, that is only the purple dress. So the purple dress is only one object, but the leather outfit is multiple objects, so they all need to be grouped together. And that is how you tell Iray, these are the things that I'd like to include. Then up here, when we actually come to rendering, we pick which node would we like to render, none, or the leather outfit, or the purple dress. Or we can create a new one. So let me go through how to set this up literally from scratch. I might just go and delete all these things again, delete all nodes. I just start exactly from scratch. Delete all this. This is disabled, and I'll go and I'll literally start from scratch. So we'll start from scratch. We have a character, and the first thing I do is render her out without canvases applied. That's the first thing. So that means we don't get any interferences from the canvases. You just render out essentially your nude character with hair though. Make sure the hair is included. And that's your first thing. You render that out as per usual. Then you set up your clothing as render layers, as canvases. So from the beginning then, on render settings, on the advanced tab, on canvases, we create ourselves one canvas. So we enable canvases first of all. Tick that tick box. We have no canvases in the list, so for our outfits we need to click this little plus icon, and it comes up by default with a beauty canvas, and that's perfect. We just want beauty canvas. We don't want anything else. Alpha is the transparency that will be added to it. If you don't tick that, you'll have an opaque background. We don't want to have that. We want to have an alpha enabled so that this is going to render with transparency. That's number one. This is essentially our first setup. Now we need to select a node here, and we don't have any nodes in our list. So we can go and either create one from selection. So that means we go over here and pick what we'd like to be included in that node. So in my case, it's the whole leather outfit. Let's go make it visible. And I'll select everything in the leather outfit here. So anything that I'd like to be included in this node, this is just going to render my outfit now. So you go and select all those, then you head over here to nodes, and where it says none, you head over and say create from selection. You can change that later, you can add things to it, you can remove things to it, but this is what you do. Add that, and then you give your node a name. So NL1 is like, you know, whatever it's called, node list or whatever, I suppose node list. And I'm going to call mine the same as the outfit. So I'll call it leather outfit, just because I get easily confused, and you know, I'd rather not get confused. So we hit accept, and that means we now have one node available at the bottom here. You can also add nodes from here, so you can just create a node without anything in it. I might do that next, and I'll call that purple dress. Add even other outfits to it, but purple dress currently doesn't have anything in it. So if you want to add or remove things from a node, that's this little icon here. So on leather outfit, if I go and click that, you'll see that these things are inside my node. But if I go and click the purple dress and click on it, nothing is inside this node. So I can add one to it. So I can just add the purple dress to it, or anything else that I'd like for it to be in there, and hit accept. And that means now I have two nodes that I can select from here, leather outfit or purple dress or no node. I can also select no node. But because I like to group my items together, I'm going to go and select perhaps the purple dress. And I believe I have to make my character and anything parented to it invisible. There we go. So that only the outfit is left over. And now I can go and just render it. Let's see if it works, shall we? Under editor, I'm just going to see if my render settings are fairly small here. Yes, they are. So size is okay. So if I render this now, it should now render me a transparent image and just the outfit that is in the node, nothing else. No, actually, that is incorrect. It's rendered nothing. Why not? That's interesting. Why did that happen? Canvas purple. Oh, because the purple dress was not selected. Sorry, I selected the wrong node here. It needs to be obviously the leather outfit as I'm showing it. The purple dress is hidden, so hence it's not actually showing. So yeah, let's go render the leather outfit. Oh my. The lights, because they're kind of, they don't need to be in the node because they are a global parameter. So lights and HDRIs, they will render it anyways. They don't need to be in this because otherwise I think the object itself would be rendered and we don't need to do that. It's just the outfits that we need. So there we go. There we have it. I think I've actually made another mistake. I'm glad I'm leaving my mistakes in as often. I can see that the hair cutout isn't here, and that's because I wasn't showing my character. So I should have actually just shown my character as well with everything that's in it. Let me go and do this again. Let me render this out one more time. And I should see now the same outfit, no character, because the character was not part of the node, just the outfit. But what I should see is things like where the hair would be. Oh, yeah, this is exactly how it happens. Cool. So this is I can see that the hair cutout is here. So everything that would be occluded by another object is also not rendered. So technically exactly what you want. So this is my outfit that I'll then save, just like I showed you in the Photoshop thing. So now if I want to go and render my second outfit, I'll leave the character in place here and I'll go and pick my purple dress. And I need to also make it available. I need to enable it. So this is how it would look like if you'd have both outfits enabled. So the purple dress is partly occluded by the second outfit. We don't want that. It would render otherwise that way. So we need to go and make sure that other outfit is also disabled. Otherwise, the occlusion would be rendered. So not the actual leather outfit on top of the purple dress, but its interference would be rendered. So that is why I need to just enable one outfit, make sure it is selected as a node, and go and render that. And that should render me now the purple dress. And also make sure you render through the same camera, so make sure the position is exactly the same, otherwise those images won't line up. I remember we used to have these kind of almost like drawing books as kids, where you had like mom and dad and two kids and they were all wearing underwear drawn, and then you had these things that you could cut out, and then with little paper clips you put other outfits on the back. This is what that reminds me of. Very cool. Yes indeed, Popeye, and then you go and layer them on top of one another in Photoshop. So if you do that with every outfit, that's one thing. But then you need to render your character. So the character is rendered without canvases, so we don't need a node for that. So you can just disable canvases and disable all the outfits and just go and render this character out as you normally would. So no canvases necessary. And that will now give you the nude character without not wearing anything and no interference from the clothing. So that's that. And then when you save all these and you import them in Photoshop, they all line up exactly like that. And then you can, I've just put a background in here so to make it a little bit more, a little bit easier to see. So that's the character, on top of which you can layer on this. The importance of leaving things like the hair out is that if there was dress underneath it now, this might shine through, this might interact with one another. You don't have to do any Photoshop work. So whoops, if you go and look at how fine this mask is that Iray already made, this is a big advantage. There we go. And then you have that effect. I hope Mick that explains it. And that lets your players on a 2D image change outfits in your game. I hope this was helpful. I'd love to share the scene file with you, but of course it would mean you'd have to have the exact same item, so I can't really do that. I might share something similar that just is made with primitives so that it'll work on everyone's installation of DAZ Studio, or I can maybe make one with the base character and with I don't know, too primitive, something like that. I'm thinking about it, just so that you get to see this this setup. But I hope this video explains it, how you need to set this up. It is, isn't it, Popeye? I like it too.